Pegs, you in?
MP parking fee. Now!
Can't operate at 4 o'clock. I've got to get off my brother.
Well, certainly. My colleague will just make a note of that.
Tell someone, Mackenzie or somebody. Tell them a call, and there's a word for that.
What's that?
Suicide.
Do you live here?
Yeah.
Yeah, then.
So.
On your ears.
Oh, I'll take them off, sir.
You think that will placate me, do you?
Sorry?
Detention tomorrow.
Yeah, but I'll go.
Or perhaps you would like to make it two.
Come on, let's go, remember.
Freedom.
What's up with you?
Just got number two detentions from Bronson.
What for?
The usual.
One for each earring.
One for the earrings, one for the sandals.
Oh, the really name.
Look at this. The romance of a summer evening. Melty's out with an outfit from our Golden Blues collection. She looked fantastic.
My sister's got one of those.
But she didn't look like that.
She's not a model, is she?
Bikinis, let's have a look.
That leopard skin one's great.
I bet you wouldn't wear that to school, Justine.
I bet she would.
Want to try it?
Oh, yeah, of course I would.
Tell me a number and I'll send off for it.
Are you joking? That's 75 quid.
Who said anything about paying? We get 7 days to try them out before we have to pay.
So we can order what we want.
And when you've tried them on, you send them back. You don't even have to pay the postage.
Yeah, but your mum won't let you.
She won't know. I'll fill in most of the forms for her anyway and post them. I'll just fill in a few numbers at the end. Simple. Tell me the
right
number then, go on.
The leopard skin one's B.
B.
We could always move this CDT set. What do you think? Excuse me. Hello? Oh, hello, Mr. Tilly. This morning? Well, I'm afraid I couldn't meet you myself. Just a moment, I'll ask my deputy. It's the managing director of the design company who are refurbishing the swimming pool. He wants to come in at 11 this morning.
Very well.
That'll be fine, Mr. Tilly. Oh, and while you're on, have you thought any more about work experience? Yes, I think I mentioned to you we've a particularly talented boy we're trying to place. He's the one who's entered the mosaic competition. You could? Oh, that would be marvellous. Thank you so much. Goodbye. I think we may have found a work experience place for Danny Kendall.
Really?
He did apologise to you, didn't he?
Oh, yes.
Good. Make sure he meets Mr. Tilly this morning because they won't be back for another month. Do you know, this time I really think he means to take on board his side of the bargain. Shouldn't you not be on your way to lessons?
Miss, she's been mugged.
Oh, no, not another one. Chrissy. Oh, Chrissy.
Should have had him. Bang, crack, that's what I would have done.
Oh, will you shut up?
Go on, Jane, and the rest of you, off to your lessons.
What's going on?
She's been attacked.
Oh, no. It's not true, Miss, is it? What Jane said. I mean, there's nothing I could have done.
Come on, Chrissy, let's get that knee cleaned up. It's time something was done about this. She's the third this week. Come on now. Justine, you got Mr. Robson first period, haven't you?
Yes, miss.
I'd like you to give him a note for me, please.
Do you know what I asked Georgie? You knocked her the night, Rob.
Yeah? What'd she say?
She turned around and said, hello.
Weren't your night, was it, mate?
Nah. I got on his dad, though. He was well out of order to throw me out that night, you know.
Oh, sorry, dude.
Should have knocked him out, shouldn't I?
Yeah.
It was your fault he got thrown out.
Yeah, Kel.
It's bad enough being kept behind for cheating without you fighting about it at Ronnie's party.
Look, you should be grateful.
What for?
Look, I don't take on every slot McCall for anyone, you know.
Grateful for being fought over like a piece of meat.
Look, he said you were stupid.
He's stupid.
I know that. That is why I hit him.
Look, I know you're defending me and all that because of what he said, but well, sometimes it's like you think I'm somebody I'm not.
So what's that supposed to mean?
Well, it's true, isn't it? I'm not Mandy Freeman when it comes to brains. If anybody criticises me at all you seem to do is see red and lash out.
And what's wrong with that?
Well, I suppose I'm saying that I don't need looking after.
Look, Cal, you know as well as I do everyone needs looking after.
Well, I don't. And if we're going to stay together, you better just realise that.
Aye, Rob, what's up with you now, eh?
Shut up.
What's up with you?
Oh, no.
Lads!
No.
Lads, I've got it now.
No.
I've got it.
No, no, no. This home ec service is totally, completely and utterly ruining my social life.
Look, all we've got to do is collect information.
No, no. It's easier said than done, that, isn't it?
Look, it's just a question of using our contacts. Ronnie knows Mandy Freeman, doesn't she?
Who?
She does.
What? He is a lunatic.
He's lover boy. Is he still out of favour?
Depends what he wants.
Yes?
Ron? I was just going to ask. How shall I put this?
Try a sentence.
Right. Well, I mean, I just thought... You know Mandy Freeman, don't you?
All right, Danny.
Yes, thanks.
Right, Mr. Tilly. Show me where this mosaic is going to be.
Oh, yes, it's here now, a bit further up the wall. We've had to relocate it very slightly. Listen, what time do you say your lad was coming? Only I am a bit pushed for time.
Come in. Yes?
Can't find Danny Kendall anywhere, sir. He wasn't at registration.
I see.
Some other time.
I'm sorry?
Well, Kendall, the lad for work experience. Shame he's not in school.
Yes. I apologize for his lack of manners.
Kendall?
You need a hat, Mr. Bronson?
No, thank you.
People are walking overhead, sir.
You find this amusing, do you?
Not particularly.
Get down from there. Move!
I'm under the impression that you had turned over in new leaf. That you were going to do us the honor of turning up the occasional lessons and interview for me. But obviously that's out of the question for someone who enjoys special privileges and to whom minor details such as the school timetable are irrelevant. Think you'd better put your hat on, sir.
So you got my note then?
Self-defense for the kids. Great.
And you'd be interested in teaching the boys?
Ah, I didn't say that.
Hey, careful on those ropes!
Too much for my ears, actually.
Okay, everybody! Hey! Hey! Equipment away, please! What do you think I am, a one-man removal agency?
You spoke to Bridget about this?
Oh, no, not yet. Why?
I just wonder what she thought.
Again, what are we going to do?
Oh, I don't know.
I'm bound to be his first victim after this morning.
Chrissy! Yeah!
Excuse me for interrupting. What is going on? Chrissy? On second thoughts, I don't think I want to know. Right, everybody get their desks back in the proper places. Yeah, you've not marked mine, Miss. Right, everybody pass their work to their neighbour.
Miss, they're not marked. Weren't they any good?
I don't know. The subject was a day in the life of a Roman slave. Now, who'd like to start? Tony Reed Johns.
A Day in My Life by B.A. Baracus.
Okay, okay.
My father belonged to a great Roman soldier called...
Sorry. Oh, thank you, Tony. Susie, read Chrissy's.
A Day in My Life by Julietta. My master has 600 slaves?
Oh, I can't read it, miss.
Neither could I. And I want them all copied out for tomorrow so that I can. Neatly! As if your lives depended on it. Imagine you're writing to Madonna or something.
Come here, boy! You predicted Bronson would say that, didn't you, Vince? I'm predicting Danny won't be back in school.
But if he picked another winner, though, then you'd have to believe it, wouldn't you?
Yeah, well, not today. I've got an...
Come on, Vince. You've got a very special gift. You must learn to use it more often.
True.
Now, listen to me, Vince. The selection must take place in total secrecy.
Rob, tell him!
Shut up, Streaky. Look, if the spirit don't move, you're tripping away. Stick your head down a car, as he can't.
What? Can I have some quiet, please, Robert?
Sure, mate. And a silver cup, right? Any post prices for next Friday.
I think it just never works. You're always so...
Robert, silence, please.
All right.
Now, Vince, I want you to close your eyes and concentrate and tell me, what can you see?
The newspaper.
Yeah, I know that's stupid, but what else can you see?
Something fishy.
Something fishy. Cheers. Something fishy. That's it. Lucky shark. Vince, you're a genius.
She said her attacker came at her from the front like this. Okay, now you come at me. See, that's one way of getting out of it. Now, come at me again, but stronger this time. Grab your arms. I sink to the ground. I lift my...
Yes, thank you.
I think I've got the point. Gracious, where did you learn these techniques? I go to a self-defense class every Tuesday and Thursday. Bit of a dark horse, aren't you? Girls should be taught not to be passive victims. They have the right to protest and the means to do so. Boys should learn macho behaviour is a sham. I think that might take a little longer. Well, I'm all for it. In principle. But
you'll have to do it on a voluntary basis.
The union won't like that.
It's not as if it's remotely connected to your subject.
I'm sorry. I really do think it's a good idea.
It's more than a good idea. Making hanging baskets is a good idea.
Where have you been?
A bit obvious, isn't it?
No, I mean I'm mulling. I called for you.
Oh, I had to do a bunk because my social worker came around.
Quit your post.
What are you doing with it?
You're not the only one good at breaking and entering, you know.
Come on, let's go and fill some forms in. My mum's auto goes today.
It's myself.
Shush. Is there somebody in there?
Picking on me and that's good, anyway. They've moved them away from the horrible prison.
It's Justine. She's reading to text. Come on.
Right. What are you doing?
None of your business. Hey, Tiggs, that's the wrong way up.
Ha, ha, ha.
Well, have a look at these and see what you think.
Working in engineering, careers in engineering, jobs in engineering. Hey, look, George, there's even a woman on the front of this one. I wonder if it'll say how many women engineers there are.
Do you think I should have agreed to go out with Ziggy?
You are joking, I hope.
Just once wouldn't hurt.
No, don't encourage him. A background to engineering. Jobs for operators, the work of technicians.
I just think I should tell him it's nothing personal. I feel a bit bad about it.
Why? Why do you feel bad?
I don't know.
Do you fancy him?
I like him as a friend.
No, it's too dangerous, George.
Well, what do you mean?
Look, George, we're talking about Ziggy Greaves here. If you make the slightest move towards him, it'd be all round the school in 10 minutes flat that you threw yourself at his feet. Now, come on, you're supposed to be helping me find out about this engineering lark. Ah, women in engineering. In 1985, there were more than 500,000 women employed in the engineering industry. Oh.
What?
However, no more than 8,500 were working as craftswomen, technicians or professional engineers. Oh, great.
I wonder what the rest were doing.
Probably sitting in the tea room talking about stupid men like Ziggy Greaves.
Shh. Come on.
Oh, so that's what all the gear was for.
Come on, McCall.
Come on.
I bet you can't play.
Yeah, but at least it's beyond bars.
Shit.
Yeah.
Come on.
Oh no, it's finished!
Oh, quick!
Look, Singleton's the one on the right, got it?
Is that this one or that one? Gone straight.
Just say straight. French when I ask.
Gone French? It's never gonna work, mate. Never.
Excuse me. Look, I won't keep you a minute. I'm sure you want to rush home, you know, to get on with your coursework. As indeed we do.
Come on.
My friends and I, we're carrying out a computer survey amongst this year's fifth formers to find the most promising pupil in each subject. Can I have your name, please? Zig.
Singleton.
Yeah, Singleton, of course, yeah. Could you look him up on our comprehensive list of fifth form ratings?
Will do.
What subject have we got him down for?
Well, he's not on my list, is he on your list?
French. French? Bien sûr. Now, we have you down as a front runner in French. Now, if you could give us some examples of your work in this subject, say 5 or 6 key translations and 12 or so pieces from your folder.
My name's Stephen Tregellum. Who have got me down for him?
Zig.
Robert. French.
Oh, no. Look, I've got a plan. So you ride the bike, run the other side of the tower block, over there. Then,
and you call to the dog. And when the dog's chasing you, I'll go into the block and deliver the papers.
What can I deliver the papers and you get chased by the dog?
Because you have no numbers. Hurry up.
I'll give you 20%.
What?
How does that sound?
It sounds like I could do it myself and get 100%.
Well, slow it.
I've got a computer at home, you know.
You can't do that.
We had the idea first, didn't we?
Yeah, besides, I mean, you're on a contract in the schoolwork, didn't you? You don't want to bother with the boring administrative side of the business. 25%.
Go on, you might as well throw in a free computer.
Yeah. But what if someone recognises my work?
Look, come here, son. There's no way, right? We've already thought about that. I mean, it's not like English, is it? I mean, every French translation is the same as another. It's just a question of getting the right word.
My friend doesn't understand the art of translation.
Yeah, I suppose it's all a question of interpretation and paraphrasing, really.
Oh, Severi. I was going to suggest that you give us several different versions of the same translation. Perhaps with different paraphrasing each time. Yeah? And so...
My bike's gone too.